ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय वासुदेवाय trying to appease them by serving them and sharing that love with actually people around the society at large. Yatra gayanti mat bhaktaha tata tishthami narva. When sincere devotees come together in the mood of trying to serve each other, to come closer to the Lord, that is what really attracts him to appear. Not only physically in a way that they can be served, but also within their heart. Mamamana mandire gahanishine Krishna Murari, Sri Krishna Murari. Bhakti Priti Mala Chanda, Tumi Niyopani Chitananda. And the worship that we offer is Bhakti Priti. Our love and devotion. So, I was thinking what I should speak today. I'll read few verses from Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, where Srila Krishnadasa Kaviraj Goswami is explaining the fifth verse of the invocation verses. Krishnadasa Kaviraj Goswami wrote 14 verses in glorification of the Panchatattva. And in the fourth, fifth and sixth verse, the external and internal reason for appearance of Sri Krishna in this world is explained. And therein, he mentions the glory of Srimati Radha. And it's so sweet, Krishnadasa Kaviraj Goswami's rendition of Chaitanya's glories in Bengali is extremely relishable, and it's extremely complicated truth is such in a very, very simple way explained and glorified in these verses. This is Chaitanya Charitamrita Adilila, text number 82. Govinda Nandini Radha Govinda Mohini Govinda Sarvasva Sarva Kanta Shiromani.
Radha
is the one who gives pleasure to Govinda, and she is also the enchantress of
end all of Govinda and the crest jewel of all his consorts. Govinda Nandini Radha Govinda Mohini Govinda Sarvasva Sarva Kanta Shiromani. I remember in 92 or 93, I joined in 89, so it was just 2, 3, 4 years probably in the movement, and I was asked to give Radhashtami class because everyone had gone for some yatra or something. So sometimes situation, you know, forces you to receive mercy. So I was in anxiety. I said, how can I speak about Radharani? Who am I? Who is Radharani? How can I speak? So I wanted to be very shastric and parampara. So I went into the library and got some cassettes straight from Prabhupada, founder Acharya. At that time we didn't have this. We had this pool, you know, with cassettes, audio cassettes. One lecture consisted of one cassette consisted of one. So I went through, and then there was one Radhashtami, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. I picked it up and then I put it in the recorder, and I, you know, prayerfully sat and I said, please Srila Prabhupada, let me know the glory, how I should speak. And Prabhupada starts the lecture. And he is speaking about glories of Krishna. 5 minutes went on, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Generally, Prabhupada doesn't speak big lectures. 15 minutes and no mention of Radharani is made. Then I kind of looked at the cassette. It is Janmashtami or Radhashtami? And when 20 or 25 minutes went on and no mention of, and glories of Krishna, how powerful is Krishna? How omnipotent is Krishna? How great is Krishna? Almost like lecture is coming to an end. And no mention of Radharani. Then I looked inside the cassette. Sometimes dabba is something and cassette is inside. Outside, everywhere it is Radharstami. And I said, how can I understand this? And lastly, in last few minutes, Krishna, Prabhupada says, and this Krishna is attracted by Srimati Radharani. Just know how great she is. Radharani ki,
Jai.
Sri Radhashtami ki,
Jai.
Mahaprasade Govinde. That's it. Just first know the glory of Krishna. We can't understand Radharani, Srimati Radharani's glory, without first understanding Krishna's glories. And when we understand Krishna's glories, then we understand, and this Krishna is completely attracted unconditionally, completely, helplessly to the love of Srimati Radharani. Then you can understand who this personality is. Then he quotes a verse, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami quotes a verse from Gautamiya Tantra. Devi Krishnamayi Prokta Radhika Paradevata Sarva Lakshmi Mayi Sarva Kantihi Sammohini Para. The transcendental goddess Srimati Radharani is the direct counterpart of Lord Sri Krishna. She is the central figure for all the goddesses of fortune. She possesses all the attractiveness to attract the all-attractive personality of Godhead. She is the primeval internal potency of the Lord. Devi Krishnamayi Prokta Radhika Paradevata Sarva Lakshmimayi Sarva Kantihi Sammohini Para. After quoting this verse from the Gautamiya Tantra, Krishnadas Goswami in every verse explains each word. What is each word of this particular glorification? If we can understand this glorification, we really know who Srimati Radharani is. So Devi, then he says, Devi kahi dyotamana parama sundari kimba krishna puja kridar vasati nagari. He says, Devi means resplendent and most beautiful. Dyotamana. Dyuti. Dyuti is the bodily effulgence. Devi means she is the ultimate effulgent, resplendent personality and extremely the most beautiful. Or else it means the lovely abode of the worship and love sports of Lord Krishna. Now Krishna is unlimited. When he wants to enjoy, he wants to enjoy unlimitedly. Krishna can expand in unlimited forms. And if somebody has to give pleasure to Krishna and to satisfy Krishna, whose desires are unlimited, whose power to enjoy is unlimited, only an unlimited personality can fulfill that. And that is Srimati Radharani. So, that is the word Devi. Dyotamana, the most resplendent, most beautiful person. Krishnamayi Krishnajar bhitare bahire yaha yaha netra pade taha krishna spure. Krishnamayi, the word Krishnamayi means one who is within and without a Lord Krishna. Yomam pashyati sarvatra sarvam chamayi pashyati tasyaham na pranashyami sachamena pranashyati. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Yomam pashyati, one who sees me everywhere and sees everything in me, I am never lost to such a person, and that person is never lost to me. He is never lost to me. This can happen when? Only when there is love. Prabhupada explains, if a mother is very much in love with a little girl, child, and the child has gone to the school, and somehow the child has not yet come back, and the mother is in tremendous anxiety, and then she, in that desperateness, she looks around, she sees the child's shoes, she sees the child's bag, she sees the child's umbrella, and she holds those things to her heart and starts crying. Where is he? Where is she? Where is my little child gone? Even though she sees the paraphernalia that is used by the child, but because it all connected with the child, she sees thavara jangama dekhe na dekhe tar murti sarvatra hoy nija ishta deva spurti. This is the ultimate perfection of life, to develop love for Krishna. And when we love Krishna, andantarastha paramanu chayantarastham govindam, and she is the ultimate abode of love for Krishna, and therefore she is Krishnamayi. Wherever she sees, she only sees Krishna. This is exactly what Lord Chaitanya demonstrated, especially in the Antilila. He would see a sand dune and she think this is Chatak Parvat, and he would think this is Govardhan. You look at the ocean, you think this is Yamuna. Anything, see a tamal tree, this is Krishna. One little peacock feather, and somebody remember Krishna. Krishnamayi. Then it says, she sees Lord Krishna wherever she casts her glance. One time, His Holiness Dhanurdhar Swami Maharaj, he was giving a class on Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Actually, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, like Srimad Bhagavatam, is the book form. We have a deity form of Krishna. The book form of Krishna is Srimad Bhagavatam. And just like we have a deity form of Srimati Radharani, the deity form of the book form of Srimati Radharani is Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Actually, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu is Srimati Radharani personified in book form. Bhakti Rasa Amrita Sindhu. It is the unlimited, shoreless and bottomless ocean of Bhakti Rasa Amrita. So if you want to understand Srimati Radharani, we should read Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. And if we get one bindu, we will get drowned. Actually, one bindu is enough to drown us. One of our devotees from Russia, he was telling. So sometimes, after Guru Puja, we are giving Charanamrita during Guru Puja. And he said he was drinking once and one drop fell down. And he looked down. Said, "Arey, Charanamrita niche giri aapko, chatunga." He went, looked down. It fell on an ant. And the ant died. In Charanamrita. I'm sure he must have immediately gone back to the spiritual world. Imagine, it falls and drowns. So similarly, Rupa Goswami, great personalities, they are drinking the nectar, Bhakti Rasa Amrita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Rasamalayam. It is the ocean of rasa they are drinking. Shukadeva Goswami is drinking. Few drops spill out. And each drop is like one verse. Sometimes one verse is enough to drown ourselves. One verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, if you really understand, that is enough to drown ourselves. Kallola magnav muhur. So, that is Srimati Radharani. So he was telling, speaking on Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Dhanurdhar Maharaj was telling, Srimati Radharani is Bhakti concentrate. We used to have rasana concentrate. Again, any put amount of water and can drink it. That concentrated bhakti. Kleshagni, Shubadha, Moksha Lagutakrut, Sudurlabha, Sandrananda Vishuddhatma, Sri Krishna, Karshani Chasa. There are three levels of bhakti. Sadhana bhakti, bhav bhakti, prema bhakti. In sadhana bhakti, you get two benefits. Kleshagni, ಚೇತೋದರ್ಪಣ ಮಾರ್ಜನಂ. ಸೊ ಕ್ಲೇಶ ಆಗಲಿ, ಶುಭದ, ಆಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ರೆಂಡರಿಂಗ್ ಡಿವೋಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಸಾಧನಾ ಭಕ್ತಿ. ಇನ್ ಭಾವಭಕ್ತಿ ಮೋಕ್ಷ ಲಘುತಾಕೃತ್, ಈವನ್ ಮೋಕ್ಷ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆಂಟ್. ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಮುಕುಲಿತಾಂಜಲಿ ಸೇವತಿ ಸ್ಮಾನ್, ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಚಯ್ಯಗ ಪಾಯಜಗ ತುಮ್ ರಖೋ ಮುಜೆ ನೈ ಚಾಹಿಯೆ, ಮೈ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಮೇ ಡೂಬ್ ರಹಾ ಹೂಂ, ನೈ ಚಾಹಿಯೆ ಮುಕ್ತಿ, ಆಪ್ ಹಿ ರಖೋ. ಮೋಕ್ಷ ಲಘುತಾಕೃತ್ ಸುದುರ್ಲಭ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ಲಿ ರೇರ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಭಾವಭಕ್ತಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೂ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟೀಸ್, ಸಾಂದ್ರಾನಂದ ವಿಶುದ್ಧಾತ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕರ್ಷಣೀಚಸ, ಇಟ್ ಅಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇವನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ. ಸಾಂದ್ರಾನಂದ, ಸಾಂದ್ರಾನಂದ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹೈಲಿ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್, ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್, ಸೋ ಡೆನ್ಸ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ನೋ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡೆನ್ಸೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮೆಟಲ್, ಲೆಡ್. ಯು ಪುಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪೆನ್ಸಿಲ್, ಲೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಈವನ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಎಕ್ಸ್ರೇ ದೇ ವೇರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೆಡ್ ಕವರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಲೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಡೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ರೇ ಪಾಸಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಥಿಕ್ ಲೇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆಗಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಪಾಸಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬೋನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಥಿಕ್ ದಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ರೇ ಕಾನ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ. ಸೊ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ರಾಧಾರಾಣಿ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೇಮ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಮ, ದೆ ಲುಕ್ ಅಲೈಕ್. ಆತ್ಮೇಂದ್ರಿಯ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ವಾಂಛಾ ತರೆ ಬೋಲಿ ಕಾಮ್, ಕೃಷ್ಣೇಂದ್ರಿಯ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಇಚ್ಛಾ ಧರೆ ಪ್ರೇಮ ನಾಮ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಪೋರಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪಾಂಜ್, ಜಿಸ್ಮೇ ಲಗಾ ಉಸ್ಮೇ ಚೂಸ್ ಲೇತೆ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಯಾಶನ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್, ವಿ ಸಕ್ ಇಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಪುಟ್ ಎ ಲೆಡ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಎನಿ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್, ಪುಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಥೌಸಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್, ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ರಾಧಾರಾಣಿ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್. ಶೀ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನೋ ಇವನ್ ಎ ನೋ ಇನ್ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆಂಟ್ ಟೈನಿ ಬಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್. ಪ್ರೇಮ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣೇಂದ್ರಿಯ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಇಚ್ಛಾ, ಹರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಟು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಟು ಕೃಷ್ಣ, ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಶಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡೈ. ಶಿ ಹರ್ ಸರ್ವೈವಲ್, ಎವ್ರಿ ಬ್ರೀತ್, ಎವ್ರಿ ಬ್ರೆತ್ ದಟ್ ಶಿ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್, ಎವ್ರಿ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಶಿ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್, ಎವ್ರಿ ಥಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಶಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೆಜರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಾಂದ್ರಾನಂದ ಕೃಷ್ಣಮಯಿ. ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಲವ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವೆನ್ ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಶಿ ವುಂಟ್ ಓಪನ್ ಹರ್ ಐಸ್, ಶಿ ವುಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ದಿ ಥಾಟ್ ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಡೆಫ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ನಾರದ್ ಜಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಹಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ಸೆಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಲ್ ರೈಟ್, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ ನಂದಲಾಲ್, ಕಾಲ್ ನಂದ ಮಹಾರಾಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ಒನ್ ಫೆಸ್ಟಿವಲ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಲ್ ರೈಟ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕೇಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟಚ್ಡ್ ಹರ್, ಲುಕ್ಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಹರ್, ಕ್ರಾಲ್ಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟಚ್ಡ್ ಹರ್, ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಶಿ ಓಪನ್ಡ್ ಹರ್ ಐಸ್. ಹರ್ ಐಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ, ಹರ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ, ಹರ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಟು ಸರ್ವ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ರಾಧಾರಾಣಿ. ಸೊ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ ನೋ ಮೋಟಿವ್, ಎನಿ ಅದರ್ ಮೋಟಿವ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅದರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಕಿಂ ವಾ ಪ್ರೇಮ ರಸಮಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣೇರ ಸ್ವರೂಪ್ ತಾರ ಶಕ್ತಿ ತಾರ ಸಹ ಹೇಕರೂಪ್. ಆರ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣಮಯಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ, ಫಾರ್ ಶಿ ಎಂಬಾಡೀಸ್ ದ ಮೆಲೋಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲವ್. ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಈಸ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಹೌ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಸನ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಸನ್ಲೈಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಸನ್ಲೈಟ್, ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣ, ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಾಧಾ ಆರ್ ಸೇಮ್. ರಾಧಾ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪ್ರಣಯ ವಿಕೃತಿರ್ ಲಾದಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿರಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಏಕಾತ್ಮನಾವಪಿ ಭುವಿಪುರ ದೇಹಭೇದಂ ಗತೌತೌ ಚೈತನ್ಯಾಖ್ಯಂ ಪ್ರಕಟಮಧುನಾ ತದ್ವಯಂ ಚೈಕ್ಯಮಾಪ್ತಂ ರಾಧಾ ಭಾವದ್ಯುತಿ ಸುವಲಿತಂ ನೌಮಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸ್ವರೂಪ. ರಾಧಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಆರ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಒನ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. One devotee was telling, I will ask you a question, one little quiz, just to make sure everyone is alert. One person asked me, is Radharani mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita? One devotee explained, it is there. Can somebody tell me, where is Radharani's name in the Bhagavad Gita? It is there in the 9th chapter, I think 13th verse. Mahatmanastumam partha daivim prakriti maashrita. That daivi prakriti is Srimati Radharani. Antaranga, Ladini Shakti. Mahatmana, they are the Mahatmas. Bhajanti, ananya manaso, gyatva bhutadi mavyayam. So she is there everywhere. Krishna can't exist without his energy, his internal energy, Ladini potency. Radha Krishna, Krishna pranaya vikriti. If you want to enjoy, you need to have one more. So the Lord expands himself into two for the purpose of loving exchange. And that is Radha Krishna. Prabhupada explains, Radha Krishna means exchange of pure, unalloyed, uninterrupted love. So Radha Krishna Leela is pure exchange of love. And that's what she is. Then he goes further. Krishna Vancha Purti Rupa Kare Aradhane Atayeva Radhika Nama Purane Vakhane. Her worship, Aradhana, consists of fulfilling the desires of Lord Krishna. Therefore, the Puranas call her Radhika. First time I came back to Bangalore after running away from home. Because it was after a long time, they gave me a surprise. About 36 members had gathered. And I was a little scared. Kya hone wala bhai? They'll put me in a jeep and take me or what? Everyone was standing and everyone's hand was behind. So I was all the more scared. Kya hone wala hai? They said, come. And they opened the gate. And I had brought one more devotee who is a Devanand Pandit Prabhu. He was in the military. So I felt very, okay, bhai, kya hoga, dekho. And as soon as I came inside, suddenly they had a lot of flower petals. They started throwing at my feet. I felt very embarrassed. I said, what nonsense you're doing? I don't deserve this. Put it in the feet of Radha and Krishna, not at my feet. Anyway, they took me inside and asked me to speak. But some of my relatives were like, dekhte hain kya bolta hai. So chuhe maarkar billi haj ko chali. Malum hai ye kya karta tha ye? Ghar ki murgi. Anyway, I spoke whatever I had heard, Srimad Bhagavatam, very fiery lecture I tried to give. I'd like to imitate. And suddenly after the whole lecture, one cousin of mine, very, very literate, we used to consider him like most learned person in our family. He came to me and he said, ye Radha, Radha, bolte hai na tum? Kahan hai Radha Srimad Bhagavatam mein? You say Bhagavatam is the highest literature. Where is Krishna's main? Where is Radharani? Anyone knows where is Srimati Radharani in Srimad Bhagavatam? Yeah, in the 10th canto, in the Ras Leela, which is Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam is like the lotus, the beautiful form of the Lord. The first two cantos are his lotus feet. Third and fourth cantos are his legs. Fifth canto is his navel. Sixth canto is his vakshasthala, his chest. Seventh and eighth are his hands. Ninth is his neck. Tenth is his beautiful lotus face. 11th is forehead and 12th is mukut. And the five rasapanchadhyay, 29 to 33, are his beautiful, transcendental, all-attractive smile. And when Krishna smiles at someone and someone is captivated, duniya lage phika phika. That's what happens. And in that, the 30th chapter, Krishna is having that Ras Leela with the gopis, and there Shukadeva Goswami controls himself not to mention Radharani's name. Because if he goes into ecstasy, then Shukadeva Goswami, Parikshit Maharaja has only 7 days. You know, if he wakes up after 10 days, he will not be able to complete Bhagavatam. And he also saw that there were so many people who are not capable actually to take this understanding. So therefore, very selectively, Shukadeva Goswami hidden way controlled his ecstasy and released it a little bit in one verse. Anaya radhito nunam Bhagavan Haririshwaraha Yanno vihaya Govinda Pritoyam anayadraha. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami quote, truly the personality of Godhead has been worshipped by her. Therefore Lord Govinda being pleased has brought her to a lonely spot, leaving us all behind. All the gopis, millions of gopis who are extremely beautiful. Lakshmi, Sahasra, they're so, much more beautiful than even the Lakshmis in the Vaikuntha planet. But without Srimati Radharani, Krishna feels no attraction. And therefore, because Radharani went away, he actually took Radha and went into a secluded place. Yanno vihaya. Therefore, he just left us. Without her, Krishna finds no happiness. Because her worship is so pleasing, so satisfying to Krishna. Then, Ata eva sarva puja parama devata sarva palika sarva jagatera mata. Therefore, Radha is parama devata, the supreme goddess, and she is worshipable for everyone. She is the protectress of all, and she is the mother of the entire universe. There is one story which I first heard when we were in Vrindavan Yatra. After that, my attraction to Srimati Radharani increased with a very selfish motive, of course. We were crossing Radhakund and we came to a place called Shivakhor. And there it was told to us how there was a jackal. I'm sure all of you know this beautiful story. But the purport of the story actually attracted me. There was a jackal, and these Brajavasi boys, very mischievous, very naughty. So they chased that jackal, and out of fear, the jackal entered a foxhole. And he was caught in that hole. And all these boys had sticks. And the jackal was caught. Then what they did was, because he went inside that hole, they put a lot of grass and dry wood and the mouth of the hole, and they put it on fire. And the jackal was shouting, and they were waiting with the stick, Anadu Bahar, we'll finish it off. And Radharani along with her sakhis were just going behind. That is her area, Radhakund is her area. And she said, this piteous cry, whose cry do I hear? Lalita, just go and find out who this is. And Lalita Sakhi went out and found out. She said, this is like that. And she saw that the jackal is burning. And, these children are beating with a stick. It was extremely miserable. And she chased away the boys, put off the fire, and picked up and brought it to Srimati Radharani. Personally, Radharani embraced that jackal and, caressed it. As soon as she actually touched the jackal, instantly it was completely pacified. And we were told how we are all like that jackal, caught in the foxhole of material existence, in the garbha, Brahma anda. Ye ande ke andar hum bhi ghus gaye. Brahmanda. Brahmanda Brahmite. We're just kind of going round and round. And samsara dhavana lalidha loka. And the three modes of material nature is constantly harassing us. And then adhyatmika, adhibhautika, the sticks they are waiting. And one more. You just escape like that. Adhibhautika. Tapatraya. Oh, yen tapatraya maraya. We use this, I never understood. Yaage ta olle tapatraya vantu ba. Tapatraya unmulanam. I never understood till I read Bhagavatam. I used to say, olle tapatraya ashte. Tapatraya. Three types of tapa. Adhyatmika, adhibhautika, adhidaivika. Constantly harassing us. We have to call out. And if Srimati Radharani hears that call. And of course, her representatives, when they hear Nikunjayuno Ratikeli Siddhyai Yayalivir Yuktirapeksh Tatrati Dakshad Ativallabhasya Vande Guru Sri Charanaravindam, they take, their representatives of Srimati Radharani come and actually help us get out, take shelter of Srimati Radharani, get out of this material existence by the process of devotional service.
Sarva Lakshmi Shabda Purve Kuryachi Vyakhya Sarva Lakshmi Ganerati Ho Hoye Adhishtham.
I have already explained in the meaning of Sarva Lakshmi. Radha is the original source of all goddesses of fortune. In the Brahma Samhita it is explained, all the Lakshmis of Vaikuntha, all the Mahishis of Dwarka, all the Gopis of Vrindavan are nothing but expansions of Srimati Radharani, unlimited expansions to give pleasure to Krishna, who is unlimited in his desire to enjoy all the flavors. Krishna is a rasaraj, you know, rasa bihari, and therefore to fulfill all the various kind of rasas, Radharani expands herself into all these personalities. As Krishna expands into Vishnu, ete cham sakala Krishna's to Bhagavan swayam. Similarly, Radharani expands her possessions, Lakshmi and the queens of Dwarka.
Then it goes further. Kimva sarva lakshmi krishne shadvidha aishwarya tara adhishtatri shakti sarva shakti varya.
Or sarva lakshmi indicates that she fully represents the six opulences of Krishna. Therefore, she is the supreme energy of Lord Sri Krishna. In fact, when we say Sri Krishna, our Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj always says, don't say Krishna direct, say Sri Krishna. Because Sri is actually a representation of Radha. All the opulences of her, Sri Krishna. You know? That's why Lakshmi, Sri Ji, Lakshmi, Radharani is called Sri Ji. She is the potency, the all attractive potency of Krishna.
Sarva Saundarya Kanti Vaise jahate sarva lakshmi ganer shobha hoye yaha hoite.
The word sarva kanti indicates that all beauty and luster rest in her body. All the lakshmis desire their beauty from her. The other day in Sri Jagannath Mandir, I was talking and I was expressing how one of Prabhupada's disciples, Rukmini Mataji, she got initiated in 1967. She had come to our temple. She was giving class and I was looking at her and I was thinking, wow, she looks so beautiful. She was late 50s and early 60s. And she was looking very beautiful. And I looked at her and said, wow, looks very beautiful. Then I said, hey, what am I doing? I'm supposed to be a brahmachari. I'm not supposed to look at Mataji's and appreciate the beauty. Then I put my head down and said, Hare Krishna, Jaya Radha Madhava. I was focusing on Kirtan. And when she spoke, she said, when she got initiated, Prabhupada gave her the beads and she took a vow. And then Prabhupada looked at her and she said, oh, you're looking so beautiful. I felt very relieved. I felt I am in parampara. After all, Prabhupada is approved, authentic. And she was, 40 years ago, she was much more beautiful, Prabhupada. And then Prabhupada, he gave me the name Rukmini Devi. And then Prabhupada, she said, gave her an instruction. And she said, for the last 40 years, I'm meditating on this instruction. Prabhupada said, oh, you're so beautiful. Gave her the name Rukmini Devi, and then he said, after giving the name, said, now I want you to become beautiful from within. Dekhne mein tum sundar ho,
अब अंदर से सुंदर बनू. एंड शी सेड लास्ट 40 इयर्स आई एम मेडिटेटिंग. व्हाट डिड प्रभुपा, ही गेव मी अ लाइफ्स मिशन टू बिकम ब्यूटिफुल फ्रॉम विद इन. एंड शी वॉज एक्सप्लेनिंग वॉट इज दैट ब्यूटी. That real beauty is the potential Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhya Kabanaya Shravanadi Shuddha Chitte Karoye Udaya. It is that love of God which is dormant within the heart of every living entity. Actually that love is none other than Srimati Radharani's mercy. Sat Chit Ananda Ananda Chinmaya Rasat Pratibhavita Abhis Tabhirya Evani Yarupataya Kalavi. It is Srimati Radharani's mercy that she has put a drop of love of hers inside every living entity's heart. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem. And when we awaken that love by the process of Navadha Bhakti, then in the eyes of Krishna, we become attractive. Krishna is not attracted by the bodily beauty. This is a fading beauty, doesn't going to last long. Shabari was not very beautiful, but what Ram, Lord Ram got attracted was Shabari's devotion. It was her devotion. So really what attracts Krishna is the love of God within, and which is none other than expansion, an insignificant, tiny, minuscule drop of Srimati Radharani's love, Ananda. She is that Ladini Shakti. She is the source. Can you imagine the unlimited ocean of that love? How much more attractive? Even Krishna is attractive. Prahlad. Prahlad, it is said, our heart, according to medical science, our heart is, if you want to know how big is your heart, you take your right hand, put your thumb inside your, and make a fist. This is the size of your heart. Okay, this is the size of your heart. If you are big fellow, then big heart. Small fellow, smart heart. But this is the size of the heart. Imagine a 5-year-old boy. Somebody here? How old are you? Get up. Come here, come here. He's 8-year-old. Can you make like this? Yeah, left, right hand. This is the size of the heart. And he's 8-year-old. Prahlad was only 5-year-old. So how big was his heart? Just think. This big heart. But he had, thank you. He had so much love in that heart that when he said, Satyam vidhatum nija, he said to his father, my Lord is present in this pillar. The Lord from Vaikuntha broke open and came out. That is the power of attraction of this much heart in this much, you know, love in this much heart. The Lord was attracted from Vaikuntha, broke open the pillar and came out just to respond to the loving call, the faithful conviction call of Prahlad. Imagine the ocean of that kind of love. That is Srimati Radharani. How will Krishna be not attracted if Radharani recommends someone to him? He says, apna aadmi hai, le lo isko. Krishna says, no, sarvadharman parityajya, kuch bhi nahi kiya ye to. Ek mala bhi thik se nahi japta hai, 16 din mein ek mala japta hai. Ye rascal ko kabhi nahi lunga. Mera aadmi hai, le lo andar. Theek hai, tu bol rahi hai to, aane do isko. Back door khol de. That's our only hope. Radharani's request, that's why in Vrindavan everyone says Radhe Radhe. No one says Krishna Krishna. Oye Krishna, bada kadak aadmi hai bhai. He's like a high court judge. Sarvadharman parite. But when the same Krishna comes in the mood of Lord Chaitanya, patra apatra na dekhe sthana sthan, jai jahan paaye tahan kare prema daan. Patra apatra na dekhe. Whether he's qualified or not qualified, yogya place, he's sitting in the temple or in the bar, still Krishna gives as Lord Chaitanya. Sthan, asthan. Jai jahan paaye, tahan kare prema daan. forcefully, you know, sometimes mothers press the nose to open the mouth so that they put the medicine inside. Similarly, Lord Chaitanya comes and presses the nose. Bol Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And you open Krishna, puts mercy inside. After drinking, you say, aur thoda chahiye? Nahi, le le, le ja. Nahi, patra nahi hai, patra ye le, patra bhi le le. He gives us the pot, he gives us the mercy and he says, cha. Still we don't understand. Because something when it is easily available, we don't understand its value. Then, further it says, Jagat Mohana Krishna Tahara Mohini Atayeva Sammatera Samastera Parathakurani. Lord Krishna enchants the world, but Sri Radha enchants even him. Therefore, she is the supreme goddess of all. One of Prabhupada's godbrother, Adikesho Prabhu, Uviyal Kapoor, he writes a very beautiful analogy. He said, suppose there is a person who is a very good, you know, whistling. Now, sometimes people whistle when they are in a good mood, they whistle. But whistling, kitna variety ho sakta hai? So he buys a flute and blows the same air inside and start playing with his fingers. What kind of variety? And that's the same air which would have come in one form as a whistle. But now when that air is blown inside and little manipulation of the fingers, millions of varieties of tunes come out. Similarly, Srimati Radharani expands herself in the heart of all the minute living entities. And when they, out of their love, reciprocate and serve Krishna in their different rasas, Krishna is very much attracted to that love. So therefore, Radharani's mercy is the love within the heart. We need to actually, make it, you know, like Bhakti Lata Beej. We have to just make it flourish.
Radha Krishna aiche sada ekai swaru lila rasa aswadite dhare dui roop.
Thus Radha and Krishna are one, yet they have taken two forms to enjoy the mellows of pastimes. And then Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in the next two verses concludes by saying,
prema bhakti shikhaite apane avatari radha bhava kanti dui angikara kari sri krishna chaitanya rupe koila avatar ehi to panchama shloker artha parachar.
To promulgate prema bhakti, devotional service to the love of Godhead, in love of Godhead, Krishna appeared as Sri Krishna Chaitanya with the mood and complexion of Sri Radha. Thus I have explained the meaning of the fifth verse. So in this way, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, please try to understand how fortunate we are in this Kali Yuga that same Radha and Krishna have combined together to relish personally and to distribute unconditionally to everyone. And this happens only in one day of Lord Brahma. How fortunate we are. Anarpita charim chirat karunaya avatirna kalav. That Srimati Radharani's love. One time, I was in our temple, Radhashtami day. And suddenly one PR department fellow called one NDTV or some TV. And one devotee came. I was, you know, doing Abhishek and all that. Prabhuji, TV wale aaye, thoda aaja udhar. Suddenly pulled me. So I went there and one lady, she put full flash on my face like this and I was like blinded and mic inside, practically like, you know, ice cream in my mouth. Stuffed me and she said, we have some questions for you. I was like, take it, remove the eyes, eye, you know, light from there. And suddenly she said, we want to know, Krishnashtami, Janamashtami is very famous. Why Radhashtami is not so famous? Isn't it? Hardly very few people know Radhashtami. Janamashtami is very famous. गोकुलाष्टमी वेरी फेमस. एंड आई वाज आराम से कहाँ अभिषेक कर रहा था, बीच में ला के माइक लगा के सब ला के, आई वाज लाइक सडनली आई सेड व्हाट एम आई टू से. एंड सडनली आई सेड लुक इफ यू वांट टू अप्रोच बिग बिग बिजनेसमैन you have to, you know, very difficult to approach him. You have to give your card and, you know, if you know someone and then you get to know him. And first time you meet him and say, tumhari patni ka naam kya hai? Usse thoda milna hai mujhe. We all know our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, right? How many of you know his wife's name? Huh? How many of you here know his wife's name? One, 2, 3, 4, exactly same proportion. Very few know. Everyone knows Krishna in whatever way. But it is not so easy to understand the heart of Krishna where Srimati Radharani resides. Radha Partha Sarathi. When Prabhupada was asked, Radha Partha Sarathi? It is a rasabhas lag raha hai. Radha and Partha Sarathi. How do you give that name? So no, wherever Krishna is, Radharani is always inside. Even in Parthasarathi, we are sitting there, Radharani is inside his heart. So, it is not, one devotee very beautifully explained, people don't understand. Then this lady asked, but Radha Krishna ka to shadi nahi hua tha na? Typical. And what am I to tell her? I said, you attend our lecture first. No, no, I have to go for another program. Quickly tell us, were Radha Krishna married? I said, your husband is also Krishna. She got a little, you know, bewildered. Then I said, recently one of our devotees, Akrur Prabhu, he is a disciple of Gopal Krishna Maharaj, temple president of Vancouver. He had come to our temple. He was giving a class, very nice class. On the 11th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, Uddhav Gita, is talking about gopis love Krishna. Then he was mentioning that all the different rasas, you know, Dasya ras, Sakhya ras, Vatsalya ras. So a woman may look at someone and say, oh, you're just like my child. Oh, you're just like my friend. She can say to someone, oh, you're just like my father. But a chaste wife will never tell another person, you're just like my husband. Isn't it? I think so. A chaste wife, I said. You know, oh, you're just like my husband. As a father, okay. As a servant, no problem. As a son, no problem. As a friend, no problem. But, as a husband, nobody will say. But actually, Krishna is the only husband because he is the husband of the soul. If the wife tells anyone else, I have a upapati, a paramour, then she is considered most degraded, immoral, according to standards of morality of Vedic culture. But if any wife says that Krishna is my only pati, she'll be worshipped. Why? Because Krishna is not only woman's pati. Shriyapati, Yajnapati, Prajapati, Dhyampati, Lokapati, Dharapati, Patirgatishchandhaka Vrishni Satvatam, Prasidatam Me Bhagavan Satampati. He is the ultimate pati, the protector, the maintainer of everyone. So all the patis, sorry, don't think you are the real patis. The real pati is Krishna. So if someone says, if anyone else other than Krishna is considered as pati, then it is considered immoral. But the perfection of morality is when you accept Krishna as your ultimate pati, jagat pati. So, and that Srimati Radharani, and who accepted, just like when even Lakshmi, when she came out, she saw everyone, but she chose the Supreme Lord as her husband. I will conclude with a nice story from our Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj's book, two series of book he has brought, Srimati Radharani. But one story is extremely, it really touched my heart and said, wow, it was very sweet. You know, pastimes of Krishna in Vrindavan. So one time, Radha and Krishna met in a kunja. And Radharani was very angry. Radharani said, what is this nonsense? Kya ho gaya? Bola, what is this? All over Braj, all the people are telling me, you are a blemish. You are Krishna Kalankini. You know, you are after Krishna. You are not chaste. You are not chaste because you always go with Krishna. Krishna Kalankini, you are a blemish. In fact, all the opponent party, they are taking pleasure in making these rumors, spending this rumor all around. And then Radharani had tears in her eyes. Everyone loves you. All the great sages, all the great devotees of the Lord love you. All the great personalities love you. They are not blamed. And what is wrong in my loving you? And if I love you, they say, oh, Radharani loves Krishna. Enough is enough. I am going to drink poison and commit suicide. Krishna said, hey, don't do like that. Give me one more day. I will set everything right. I will make your purity, let it be known to the whole world. Just give me some time. Radharani said, no. Next day, early morning, Krishna was lying. Suddenly developed extreme fever. And Yashoda Mai came and touched and what is happening? And Krishna fainted. Seeing this, practically dead, no life symptoms also of Krishna. Seeing that, Yashoda Mai fainted. Seeing that, Nanda Maharaj came. And he was like shocked. And he sent people in all directions. Go and find a Vaidya. Go and find one Vaidya. Unfortunately, no Vaidya was available nearby. Nanda Maharaj was disappointed. He was coming back. Right in front of the gate of his house, there was one Vaidya standing. Ready-made. Directly at the gate itself. And this Vaidya, beautiful looking personality, little darkish complexion. He had a book, Shastra, you know, Ayurvedic textbook in one hand and a lot of medicine bottle inside the other. And he said, come here. Do you know who I am? I am the Vaidya Raj. I am the best of the doctors. I was just going around. This is what we are looking for. Please come, come in. All right. If you want me, I'll come. And then he came inside. And I said, please do something. My Neelmani is fainting. I mean, he's going to die. Do something, Yashoda Mai said. So this doctor, who's none other than Krishna himself, expansion, he came and touched the pulse. I know exactly what the diagnosis is. And to tell you the truth, I have good news. This medicine is only for this disease. But I have a problem. I said, what is the problem? Please tell, what is the problem? We'll solve any problem. Very difficult problem. Acha, I need an anupan. Anupan means, you know, just like they say, doctors give some medicine and say, isko honey mein dal ke khana, isko garam pani mein dal ke khana. So that anupan means, in which when you put the medicine, it becomes potent. So I need that anupan. Hey Baba, tell what that anupan is, wherever it is, we'll get. No, this is very difficult. Then he thought, managed everything. I said, okay, this anupan means the most chaste person in the whole of Brajbhumi must be called. And that chaste lady should carry a pot which has 1,000 holes. And he cut a bunch of hair, the doctor cut a bunch of hair from Krishna's, you know, locks of hair, one lock. And he said, I'll make a bridge out of this hair. So they have to climb over this bridge, go in the middle of Yamuna and pick up and bring that. From there they should come here. And no water should fall from that holes. That water brought by a chaste lady in a pot containing 1,000 holes. In that, if I put this medicine, your son will get up. Yashoda Mai and Nanda Maharaj announced, sab chaste lady ko bula, could you be here? And everyone came. Oh, we can serve Krishna. And everyone came. And then they would go. Imagine a pot with 1,000 holes. As soon as they, everything would fall. They were so ashamed, they went away. Then, seeing that no chaste lady is able to do that, then Yashoda Mai said, I will go myself. If I have devotedly served my husband, then I'll surely get it. Doctor became in anxiety. The doctor called Nanda Maharaj, come here. Patient's mother is not allowed. Disqualified from being here. Patient ka mother nahi chalta. Dusra vakti hona chahiye. Nanda Maharaj said, okay. Yashoda, sit down. I said, okay. What? Jatila and Kutila came. Radharani's sister, Kutila, and Radharani's mother-in-law, Jatila. Kutila would always criticize Radharani. She is most unchaste lady. She always goes with Krishna. First, Jatila came. Jatila said, today, the whole Braj Bhumi will know how chaste we are to our husband. Okay, she picked the pot and she went. She went inside. And four people had to drag her. Chaste lady, come out. She was terribly insulted. Kutila said, don't worry, mom, I'll go. And she kept 1 foot and she also went inside. Four people had to drag her. They became extremely angry. If we are not chaste, then even Parvati, it cannot be chaste. This is nonsense. But the point is, Krishna is dying. So Yashoda Mai said, is there no one? And Nanda Maharaj said, doctor, dekho, kuch to karo. Calculate. Is there anyone in this place who can? The doctor said, let me think. And he started drawing lines and all kinds of yantra, tantra. And he was drawing, So, kya ho gaya? There is one lady who is extremely chaste. Radharani. Call her. Instantly Radharani was called. She came along with her sakhis. And everyone is looking, jaane do, dekhenge, pata chalega. Radharani took that pot and she started walking on the banks of the Yamuna. And there, this hair, can you imagine? A bridge made of hair. She prayed, desperately, sincerely prayed to Krishna. And she started walking on that bridge. And everyone was like, how is she walking? Right in the center of Yamuna. And she took that pot and she prayed intensely. And then she looked in the water. In the reflection, Krishna was smiling. And she picked up. And as she was picking it up, Krishna, Vishwarup Darshan, I think, he expanded. 1,000 fingers came and stuck into all the holes. There was Krishna's fingers everywhere. And she looked and she saw Krishna's face inside that. And she stood there for some more time and she told Lalita and Vishakha, look, is there any leakage of water going? And both of them checked, ekdam perfect. Then she took it. And then she took it and placed it. And then all the ladies standing there, Sakhi, did you see? You are thinking that she is like that. But actually, she is the height. She is such a chaste lady. And then the doctor said, Anupan. She, from your own hand, you pick three palmful and put it. And then he made that medicine and fed it to Krishna. And Krishna suddenly woke up. Kya hua? Kuch nahi hua, as if nothing he knew. Krishna woke up. And everyone embraced. And Mother Yashoda was so happy. And she took so much butter and milk and gave it to Srimati Radharani. Radharani said, no, I'm not going to eat this. Then she fed it to Krishna. And Krishna's Mahavant was given. She immediately honored it. And in this way, Krishna declared to the whole world through this beautiful pastime, whole of Braj Bhumi, don't you ever dare question the chastity of Srimati Radharani. This Upapati Bhav, Parakiya Bhave Jaha Brajete Prachar, this Parakiya Bhav is not to be ever. Otherwise, Lord Chaitanya, Sukadeva Goswami, the greatest sages, the greatest alvars, the greatest acharyas in all the four sampradayas would not have glorified Radha and Krishna had there been any tinge of any mundane lust in this. What is Srimati Radharani's mercy? This morning, after getting up, I was kind of, right? In their house, they have, Brajchandrika Mataji's, in that cupboard, there is a big Radha Madhav photo. Beautiful, big-eyed Srimati Radharani. And I was praying, Radharani, and I was thinking, what is your mercy? How can I understand? And then suddenly one thought came to my mind. Bhagavad Gita starts with Aham Mameti, Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva, and goes to Sarvadharman Parityajya, right, in the later chapters. Where Gita ends, Bhagavatam begins. Dharma Projita Kaita Votra Paramo. And builds up to Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya. And in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam goes to the Madhurya Ras of the beautiful pastime of Radha and Krishna and their Rasleela. Where Bhagavatam ends, Chaitanya Charitamrita begins. And who is Lord Chaitanya? Anarpita Charinchirat Karunaya Avatirna Kalav. Unnata Ujjala Rasam Sabhakti Shriyam. It is Krishna with the bhava heart and the bodily complexion of Srimati Radharani. And do you know what is the last chapter of Chaitanya Charitamrita? Anyone knows what is the title of the last chapter of Chaitanya Charitamrita? The Shikshashtakam prayers. In the madness of the love of Srimati Radharani for Krishna, Lord Chaitanya would go mad, completely mad, the ultimate Mahabhav. And that time, he in that madness spoke the Shikshashtakam prayers. And Burijan Prabhu in his book mentions these Shikshashtakam prayers, the 8 prayers recited by Lord Chaitanya in that mad ecstasy of Lord Krishna in the mood of Srimati Radharani is the description from Adav Shraddha to Prema and also the prescription. It is a description of the stages of love and the prescription for all us conditioned souls, which begins with Cheto Darpanamarjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapana Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam Nam Nam Akari Bahudha Nija Sarva Shakti. Krishna has put Kali Kale Namarupe Krishna Avatar. Krishna has manifested himself mercifully in the form of his holy name. That Rasa Leela is none other than Harinam Sankirtan of Lord Chaitanya. Can you imagine in Srivasa's house Rasa Leela used to happen in the form of Lord Chaitanya's Kirtan, that is Rasasthali. Even Jagai Madai had entry there. In Rasleela, Lord Shiva could not enter. Naraji could not enter. Lakshmiji stands in Bilvavan. No entry to Radha Krishna's Rasleela. But in Lord Chaitanya's pastime, after the deliverance of Jagai and Madai, they entered. They entered. And there is no misunderstanding in Lord Chaitanya's Leela. Because it's all, Panchatattva performing these beautiful pastimes. So truly Srimati Radharani's mercy on which we can meditate today and pray is actually the holy name which is given by Krishna in the form of his devotee, in the mood of Srimati Radharani, like a teacher writing ABCD to teach, children how to write. It's not the teacher learning her ABCD. She's coming down to the level of the students to teach. So how fortunate we are that Srila Prabhupada traveled all over the world leaving Vrindavan to bring Vrindavan to the whole world. To bring Radha Krishna's love to the whole world. This movement is called Hare Krishna. Hare means Srimati Radharani. This Radha Krishna's movement, which is the highest love, is brought to us. So on this day we can pray at the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani that we may have some understanding, some appreciation for this movement, the Hare Krishna movement, and especially the Harinam Sankirtan, individually and collectively to come together. Sankirtan, Samyak means body, mind and intelligence, everything to be engaged, body, mind and words. And Sankirtan collectively means to come together harmoniously, keeping all other designations aside and glorifying. And then Radharani's mercy will flow. And like here, she is offering her love to Krishna. You know? And all this she collects and she offers it to Krishna. And then our life will be successful. Radhashtami Mahamahotsav ki. Jai Jai Sri Radhe. Sha. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.